This video provides information on common questions and important things you need to know about subdividing your site. Where possible, new driveways should preserve existing street trees and not impact infrastructure such as signs, bus stops, or side entry pits adjacent to the land. If your new driveway requires removal of a tree, approval is required from council to remove the tree, and if approved, a fee is payable by the applicant. If the tree is a regulated or significant tree, which has a trunk circumference greater than 2 metres when measured at 1 metre above ground level, you may only remove the tree under certain conditions. If there are other obstructions, such as signs, bus stops, or power poles, the asset owner must be consulted during the process. Accordingly, all street features must be identified and every effort made to maintain a suitable clearance from them as outlined in the Planning and Design Code. Significant and regulated trees on the site or neighbouring sites must be identified and steps taken to protect the tree roots and canopy. If there is a significant or regulated tree within 20 metres of the site, you may need to engage a qualified arborist to provide a report. To determine if it's regulated or significant, you will need to measure the tree. For help on how to measure the tree, please visit Council's website. If the property is located on a main road, access may be restricted, or future dwellings may have to be set back further on the site to allow for on-site manoeuvring. In addition, there may be road widening requirements which affect the development potential of the land. Information to help you identify if your property is on a main road can be found on the Plan SA website. For further information on the land division process, please contact Council's planning team.